welcome you to an evening of reflection and celebration. Reflection on the need for our engagement with one of the most intractable problems of our times, that is India's poverty, and how all of us can engage with doing something about it. And celebration of what Pradhan over the last 29 years has done, is doing, and is continuing to do.
Pradhan was set up. It was very clear to Pradhan founders, my friends Vijay Mahajan and Deep Joshi, the idea was to innovate at a scale that would then influence the mainstream, both at the policy level as well as in program implementation.
We move to the next part of the agenda, which is really to highlight for you, as I said, what is different and what is distinctive about this organization. And it is my proud privilege to invite three people up here. The first one of them is Deep Joshi.
Next, my friend Vijay Mahajan. And finally, I would like to
invite the
seventh executive director of Pradhan, Manas. Are you here? Hi, Manas. And maybe, Deep, we can start with you. And, you know, can you give us some context for the kind of work that Pradhan does? Both the context that existed when you all started 30 years ago, and if you feel the context has changed today and what it is right now.
As we have grown, as Pradhan has grown, as we've had more experience, we have learned ourselves that essentially large part of poverty is not about money and policy and so on and so forth. It's about people's own sense of agency, people's own sense of capability, people's own confidence. And of course, simultaneously, you also need to create opportunities, you need to innovate, you need to come up with new ideas. So that's the context that I think is Pradhan.
So Vijay, over to you now. I've been really fascinated ever since I've gotten involved in the way this organization model works. So one, if you could talk a little bit about, as you conceived of the, yes, we were bringing high quality professionals, but internally the way you've organized this and the way it has grown is actually quite remarkable. And if you could talk about that a little bit, I thought it'll be quite valuable.
When we got this opportunity, and indeed Pradhan's long name, which is Professional Assistance for Development Action, kind of explained in an elaborate phrase what one was trying to do, that we were professionals, but we were trying to assist people like Loknathanji, who were really at the cutting edge of development. And what I'm delighted about is that 30 years hence, the action orientation of Pradhan is so deeply embedded in its genetic code that, I mean, even today, on its 30th anniversary, on its biggest day, I think 70-80% of Pradhanites are not here. And they're probably right now finishing some SHG meeting or some producer organization meeting and just getting home on their motorcycle, you know. So that is what is amazing about this thing.
Manas, and you are the person taking Pradhan forward. What are the plans? If you could quickly cover some of the plans for the near term.
Some new initiatives and plans I would like to share. One is that we are going to initiate a course with Ambedkar University, Delhi, on development practice. It was a long cherished desire in Pradhan to mainstream our experience of building apprentices. So finally, we could do it, and we are going to start this course very soon. Second, I would say that we have initiated partnership with many more NGOs to reach the poorest pockets of the country. We have partnership with around 70 organizations now across this Central India tribal belt. We have one National Rural Livelihood Resource Center to continuously support action by civil society. Today, on the commencement of 30th year of Pradhan, we are launching the capital campaign to raise a corpus of around $30 million, so that at least one third of our cost can be made from the income of corpus. So that's the initiative, and we are looking forward to it, to connect to many more of the friends here and to be able to do much more of what we are doing.
All the very best. Thank you. Thank you, Vijay. Thank you, Deep. Thank you for sharing your thoughts. Thank you very much.
All the best. We are very grateful that Mr. Jairam Ramesh, the Union Minister for Rural Development, is here with us as the chief guest for this 30-year celebration. At this point, I would request him to please come up here, and Vijay, if you could please present him our shawl before he starts to speak.
Tassar from Pradhan.
Tassar from Pradhan.
Thank you very much. Well, I congratulate Pradhan, I congratulate Deep and Vijay Mahajan for an outstanding achievement. Farm professionals are actually working in some of the most challenging of areas, and I really want to congratulate all of them. I've seen many of them, and in fact, on the 29th of this month, we're going to have a forum in Dumka, in Jharkhand, where all the NGOs working in the state of Jharkhand are being collected, and they're going to congregate in Dumka, and we are trying to explore how we can scale up the activities of these NGOs. I want to make a specific mention of two recent initiatives in which Pradhan has played a very important role, both in the thinking through of these initiatives and in giving a detailed design to the architecture. One is an initiative that the finance minister announced in the budget, which is to establish a Bharat Rural Livelihoods Foundation. It's the primary objective of this foundation is to work in the central Indian Adivasi belt in recognition of the point that Deep made, that if there is one community that has really not seen the full benefits of the profound economic transformation that India has seen over the last 5-6 decades, it's the central Indian Adivasi. The second initiative that I want to mention is a recent initiative that we have launched just about 10 days ago called the Prime Minister's Rural Development Fellows. And this was an initiative that we have taken to give an opportunity for young Indians fresh out of graduate schools to come and spend 2 years working in this belt, the central Indian belt. That's the only thing. So with those few words, I thank Pramath and wish you all the very best.
Jairam, you need to release a book that has been published on the occasion of the 30th anniversary. Actually, you just showed a cover. There are three books. Thank you very much, sir, for being here and spending so much time with us. Few people here who I would just like to call up on stage and recognize. And I would, after they come up here, I'd just like you to give them a big hand because of what they do. So the first one is Achintya Ghosh. Achintya, if you can come up here. Achintya has been with Pradhan since 1983. He's in charge of Rajasthan. He's an expert in water management and irrigation. And he was an executive director between 1997 and 2001. Satyabrata Acharya, with Pradhan since 1989, in charge of Jharkhand and an expert in tussle-based livelihoods. Arnab Chakravarti, with Pradhan since 1994, in charge of West Bengal and my state of Bihar, thank you, since 1993. Madhu Khetan, since 1991 with Pradhan, in charge of Madhya Pradesh, with a special interest in women's empowerment and gender equality.
Saroj Mahapatra, with Pradhan since 1996, in charge of Chhattisgarh and with a special interest in INRH. Narendranath, in charge of knowledge management and a special interest in social mobilization. Again, Naren has been with Pradhan since 1989. Nivedita Narayan, in charge of here since 1987, in charge of HR, put together the HR process over the last two decades. Anirban Ghosh, in charge of operations with Pradhan since 1994. And Anish Kumar, in charge of finance, He's the guy who manages the purse strings, and he's been with Pradhan since 1994. I'd just like you to give them a big hand. Thank you.